Hello, welcome to another show about Basic by Living. Well, summer is heating up the country in these days, but in Hanoi City, the temperature is rising even higher with the taking place of the 2013 Asian Freestyle Football Championship. Participated by over 40 competitors from different Asian countries, including Vietnam, the event held for the first time in Vietnam and yet another flavor to the local scene of sports and entertainment. But before coming to the event, let's get some common knowledge about what freestyle football is and who's behind this thing.
Hoài Nam Nguyễn, or Nam the Man, is a Vietnamese born and raised in Dublin, Ireland. He's billed as one of the world's iconic freestyle footballers. With years of professional experience, Nam is one of the most highly sought after and experienced freestyle football athletes in the game. He won the Combo Championship competing against world-class athletes, the European Red Bull Street Style Championship and the All Ireland Champion. With a desire to develop freestyle football in Vietnam, Nam has been traveling back to the country many times and transferring his inspiration about the sport to local youngsters. This man hopes that Vietnam would one day become a big name in the world's map of freestyle football. Every time coming back to Vietnam, Nam brings with him something new. For the past years, this Irish-born freestyler has spent a lot of time and money to develop the country's freestyle football from scratch.
I really want to contribute to my home country. Even though I was born in another country, in Ireland, I love freestyle football. It's my passion. And when I came back to Vietnam in 2010, the beginning of the year, what I wanted to do was to just push football freestyle in Vietnam, because it's such a football country. Everybody loves football and it's such a new sport. So I thought, you know, I think I'm in a good position to do that with my network internationally.
With the AFFC spends in the past years, Nam the Man has succeeded in setting the trend for freestyle football in the country. It's him to introduce the sport to local youngsters and fuels the passion for freestyle football. And now let's follow me and we'll see how freestyle football is developing in Vietnam.
Searching in the internet, it's easy to see thousands of video clips about Nam's performances around the world and also in Vietnam. Watching those clips, some Vietnamese youngsters fell in love with the sport, and then a trend of freestyle football started to grow in Vietnam.
Anh Nam chính là người mà đưa bộ môn bóng bàn kỹ thuật này về Việt Nam, và qua chính là qua những clip mà anh Nam biểu diễn trên đường phố, và bọn em đã lấy cảm hứng rất nhiều từ những clip của anh Nam rồi men.
Lúc đầu thì em không nghĩ là anh là người Việt Nam, nhưng mà khi xem một clip anh ấy mặc một chiếc áo cờ đỏ sao vàng thì em đã nghĩ là chắc đây là người Việt Nam rồi. Sau đó em thấy rất là hay và rất là hâm mộ nên em đã tập theo môn này.
From just a few people at the beginning, the number of freestylers has increased to around 100 in recent years. Similar to the regional scene of freestyle football, Vietnamese freestylers form different groups, train together, and compete with each other. The reputation of Vietnamese freestyle football even spread to other countries, attracting foreign players. Andrew and Law are two freestylers from Hong Kong. Becoming friends with Vietnamese freestylers via the internet, they decide to spare some time of their vacation in Vietnam to join with local players.
In Hong Kong, we also used to perform on the street. It's a very good opportunity for us to perform, to let people know more about the sport.
Witnessing the rapid growth of freestyle football, Nam starts to have bigger plans.
Bringing freestyle football to Vietnam is what Nam the Man hopes, but that's not everything he wants. In fact, this Vietnamese-Irish man wants to bring Vietnamese freestyle football to international level. And that's why he brings the Asian Freestyle Football Championship to the country for the first time.
After getting success with the organization of National Freestyle Football Championship event, Nam the Man and his friends bring the first International Freestyle Football Championship to Vietnam this year. The event is expected to offer domestic freestylers opportunities to compete with skilled international players.
Truthfully, I invested financially myself and also the time, because I just believe that this sport is just going to grow in Asia. And it's, you know, if nobody's going to do it, you know, I guess I have to put myself in that position to do it. I'm really sure that, you know, many kids will pick it up. It's very beneficial to them, their health, and, you know, networking with people, communicating and socializing also. There's many different aspects to the sport and how it can benefit everyone.
Nam brought up the idea of doing a championship. Firstly, he mentioned the first one, which was the Vietnam Football Freestyle Championship, which was done. And then he said, now let's try to do something bigger. Let's try to do Asian. And I said, yeah, let's go ahead and do it.
Soon after arriving in Vietnam, the 19 foreign freestylers from different Asian countries and territories joined with Vietnamese ones in training sessions. And just through the training session, competitors realize how tough the regional championship this year is.
To be honest, I think the level is really have gone up tremendously throughout the past years, and this year I think it was really very tough. Every country is have really top freestylers, so I think it's very interesting to watch the competition this year.
Việt Nam muốn có một cái thứ hạng cao trong bảng xếp hạng, và trong cái giải đấu này thì cần có một sự tập trung và tập luyện rất là tốt thì mình có thể đấu và giao lưu với các đối thủ của nước khác.
I like this city, Hanoi, and I like Vietnam. I'm so excited, and I want to win.
This is Bilal B, a famous freestyler in the UAE. Bilal, Mr. Wu from Korea, and Nam the Man will be the judges for this year's event.
Actually, I got invited from the Asia Freestyle Federation. It's very nice. I'm very happy to be here. The level is really high. I haven't seen all the freestylers yet, but I can tell they have improved a lot since 2008, 2010, 2011.
And soon the players are ready for the battles. The complex behind the Indochina Plaza Hanoi is where the event this year took place. Hours before the championship kicked off, Vietnamese and foreign players already gathered at the venue, eagerly waiting to compete. But one unexpected thing happened and brought changes to the event: the rain. The event has to be moved to an indoor stage, but for competitors and organizers, that's not a big problem.
I think it's better to have it indoor. It's a bit cooler, it's not so hot, and there's no wind here, so lucky for me.
The floor has a lot of dust, that's why the ball is sometimes slippery, like it's hard to do some tricks. But if you have enough experience, it's okay, you can deal with that.
In the first round of the championship, Competitors were divided into different groups and performed individually. Two players with highest scores in the group would advance to the next rounds. During this round, foreign players are quite optimistic about their chance to get past.
I hope I can get top 16 in Asia.
I hope I go as far as possible.
After giving a few advices for the competitors, the second round begins. In the second round, players will join in one-on-one battle. Every player has 90 seconds to impress the jury board. When the two players finish their performance, judges will make their decision based on their own evaluation. From the second round, unexpected results were witnessed with the victory of some Vietnamese players over strong foreign freestylers. According to judges, they do all the best to keep the competition fair.
There were a lot of disappointments with some of the players, but you know, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, that's the story.
We do our best and as much as we can, and to be fair. So I think hopefully they all respect for that.
The rule for the next rounds is quite the same to that of the second round. Freestylers all have 90 seconds to show all their tricks, styles and creativeness. Who were chosen by more than one judge get to the next rounds. But the further they advance, the tougher opponents they have to face. With certain advantages for local supporters and being the host country, Vietnamese freestylers surprisingly took out all the foreign competitors. The final battle was only the business between Vietnamese freestylers. Unprecedentedly, Vietnamese freestyler grabbed all the top three positions in the regional championship this year, and that opened the door leading them to the international arena.
Nói lên là Việt Nam mình tuy nhỏ bé hơn nước khác nhưng mà về khả năng sáng tạo các kỹ thuật thì không hề kém nước nào khác. Và em tin là trong một vài năm nữa rồi Việt Nam sẽ có thể vươn lên tầm thế giới.
Việt Nam sẽ có hai đại diện tham dự giải vô địch bóng đá thế giới tại Praha, Czech vào tháng 8. Rất là vui ạ.
And while the Vietnamese boys are busy celebrating, the trendsetter of Vietnamese freestyle football is thinking of his next plans.
This is the first official event. I mean, the next event, I'm sure it's going to be even bigger and better with more international athletes.
For many of these foreign freestylers, this is the first time they come to Vietnam. Joining the competition is the main purpose of their visit, but apart from that, getting to know about Vietnam, its history, culture, and people is another great experience for these youngsters.
I live in Sweden, but I'm actually, my father is from Manila, Philippines. And there it's a very different, there is very crowded. And where I live, there's only 1,000 people. In Gantofta, there's only 1,000 people. So there's no relics or monuments like that.
Comparing to their countries, Vietnam is less developed. But for these young boys, that's the thing that makes the country attractive. With lakes, green trees, historical features, and peaceful lifestyle, Vietnam has become part of the story they tell to their friends when they are back.
I saw a lot of history here, and it was great. I can't forget this experience.
It's full of nature, like grass, trees, and like that. Some countries don't have that. They just have buildings and technology, you know. This is like more nature country.
Soon after the competition, all of them will come back to their home country. But for sure, they will not forget about the things they see, the people they meet in the trip that made possible by the passion for freestyle football.